Hello guys, welcome back. I'm your friend Nawaf and you're watching my YouTube channel Shipmate Nawaf Qazi. Today I'm here to discuss about the lifeboat drills which we do on board, and today specifically we are going to take into account the enclosed lifeboats on board and what are the safety precautions to be taken prior carrying out a drill. As you guys are aware, many incidents are happening because of improper use of the lifeboats during the drills. The lives gone during the drills are more than the lives saved by the lifeboats. So guys, it is very important to take this business seriously, and let us see what are some quick wins which can help us to at least ensure that there are no casualties, no safety lapses and no incidents while doing this operation. Come on, let's see. Number 1. Know your lifeboat properly, guys. Guys, enclosed lifeboats are basically, they have the same principle for lowering, launching and recovery. And if you know it on one ship, it is going to be pretty similar on all other ships. Take that interest, take that effort, and it is really very, very easy. There are major two issues associated with enclosed lifeboat while launching and recovery. Mostly during recovery is, first, improper resetting of hooks. It is the most important part in an enclosed lifeboat, that if your hooks are not reset properly, most of the incidents have happened that due to improper resetting of hooks, the hooks opened up, or either both or one hook opened up and the lifeboat fell into the water or hung on one side and then eventually the wire parted. Here comes the second most lapse. The second one is parting of the wire for the lifeboat. So these two things are very important. So know how to reset your lifeboat, know how to use the FPD. I will not go into detail, minute details about what is FPD and how to use it. But yes, FPD you should know, you should use it. And resetting of the hook is the very important point. And your wires, maintenance of the wires, well lubricated, and inspection. All this if you follow, your 95% of the job is done, wherein you could be pretty sure that your lifeboats are safe to be used in case of an emergency as well as during the process of routine drills on board. Yes guys, the point number one was the basic preparation every time you do on board for lifeboats, and it has to be done by all the crew. Now the second point is just before the lifeboat launching exercise is being done. Guys, don't rush. Keep your permissions well in place. Before you arrive the port and you plan for doing the exercise of launching your lifeboat, take your permissions, inform the agent or VTS, whatever is the procedure for that port, and keep your permissions in hand. Once you reach the anchorage or the port where you want to do the exercise, very important is the weather conditions. Check the weather conditions, and guys, weather conditions does not mean only the wind and the sea. It is very important to note the currents also. There might be strong currents, and if the boat, for any reason, if the engine is not starting or it is stopped, the boat can drift away really fast from the ship and it will be very difficult to recover back if there is no painter. So weather conditions is very important. Don't take that unnecessary risk to put your boat and your crew just for the purpose of drill when the weather is really bad. Wait for the good weather and you can do it. As per me, point number 3 is the most important point. Select your team for the lifeboat operation. The guys who are going inside the boat, make sure they are competent for the operation. Yes, I know everyone on board must be competent for operating lifeboats, and that is all okay. But rather than taking a OS who is first time on board or first time in the company or who is working with the enclosed lifeboats for the first time, take a AB who has done these operations number of times and who knows about it, because this is a critical operation. We need to understand, yes, everyone should be well versed in doing this operation, but guys, how often do we do this on board? The requirement is 3 monthly requirement for waterborne. Okay, so in a contract of 6 months, a AB might get a chance to do it only 2 times or maybe only 1 time. So it is an operation which is not done very frequently. So you need your guys who are experienced. And the very important point is a toolbox talk just before the operation. It is very, very important. Brief your guys, the guys who are going inside the boat, the guys who are going to be standby on the boat deck and doing the operations like lowering or recovery of the boat. It has to be very important that there is no, it is very important that there should be no confusion between these two teams. These are two individual teams, and the biggest challenge that a person faces inside the lifeboat is communication. So the communication should be effective. So if your team, the coxswain, the person who is standby on forward part of the boat, and the person who is going to handle the aft hook, if they are clear about what is the plan, then there are no hassles, and there is chances that the confusion will be very less, or there won't be any confusion at all, and your operation will be hassle-free and trouble-free operation. Make sure the movement of the boat from the davit to the boat deck is smooth and continuous. Don't give jerks, don't stop the boat in between. Let it run smoothly and let it come and rest onto the boat deck. Yes, it should be smooth enough like that, and then stop once it is on the boat deck. The guy who is operating the brake should be very clear about this, because if he starts giving jerk, the boat is going to swing abruptly and might even result in jumping of the wire from the shoe. Then let the boat lower slowly. You can lower it from inside the boat from the self using the self lowering wire also, and make sure the instructions are very well clear with the both the teams, the team which is inside the boat as well as the team which is on the boat deck. The boat is then lowered, and is lowered just 0.5 meter above the water level, because we need to take out the FPD once the boat is 0.5 meter above the water level. If the boat is waterborne along with the FPD, it will be very difficult to take out the FPD. And guys, remember one thing: as soon as the boat is in water, it is the sea waves which are going to hit on the boat. However calm the weather, the boat is going to have certain movement, and that will not allow you to take out the FPD. So when now the boat is 0.5 meter above the water level and we have taken out the FPD, once FPD is clear, guys, sit down again and we make the boat fully waterborne. The communication has to be very clear, and now the boat is going to get fully waterborne. FPD is clear, boat is resting only on the boat hooks, and there is a painter on the forward part you can see which is made fast. Now the boat is waterborne. After you ensure that the boat is waterborne by checking the hydrostatic unit, make sure that you release the hooks from inside the boat, and the first thing you have to do is move away from the ship, because even if the swell is very small, the boat is, once it is free from the hooks, it is going to come and hit on the ship side, or it is going to come and hit on these hooks which you see now. But once the boat is away from the ship, you are safe, you are on your own, nothing is going to happen. If you feel discomfort, you can open the hatches, breathe in fresh air, this is normal. First thing, as soon as your boat is moved away from the vessel, you have to do is to reset your hooks. Reset your hooks back well in time to the normal position. Try, check, and be ensured that your hooks are reset properly. So after the instructions are given to the forward boat hook handler and the aft, they open the hatches, they come out and they reset the hooks. The next important part is resetting of the hooks, which is not a very complicated procedure. The boat handlers just have to come and keep the hooks and hold them with hands in the close position, and when they are doing so, from the coxswain position, the lever is brought back again to the normal position and pin put in place. Also on the hooks there is a marking for green and red. The hooks should be in green, indicating that the hooks are reset. Also the lever has to be smooth. I mean, you do not have to apply any extra effort for the lever to bring back into normal position. Once that is done, we try out the sprinklers. All the hatches are closed, sprinklers are tried out. We check whether there are any leakages inside the boat. If any deficiency, we have to note it down so that it can be repaired at a later stage. We take a lot of pictures as an evidence that the drill has been done and it is not just logged on paper. So once the sprinkler is tried out, guys, we are done with almost all our drill procedures. We have used the engine to move ahead and astern. We have tried out the sprinkler. hooks are reset. Now the next procedure is we will move back to the vessel. Guys, as you can see, throughout this operation there is one painter tied on the forward part of the boat. It is very important to keep this painter in place because this is the only point of contact between the vessel and the lifeboat. Now you can just leave this painter slack in water and just keep it tied on the ship, so that in case if it is required we can use it. Some guys prefer tying both the painters, one forward, one aft, but I usually don't prefer that, because if both the painters are tied on the vessel, it is very difficult for your boat to move away from the vessel, and that results in unnecessary banging of the boat on the ship side, and also might result in other complications. So I usually keep only one painter made fast, the forward painter, and the aft painter is released, because the one more problem associated with the aft painter is that if it is slightly slack, it can get caught in your propeller, and that is why I release the aft painter. I am clear on my aft, my engine is free to use, and I just keep the forward painter so that I can also use it to handle my boat when I come close to the ship, or if the engine fails or something happens and I am not able to use my engines, then the painter can be used to bring the boat alongside. So it is very important to keep this painter always made fast. And now, as you can see, I am proceeding towards the hooks. Now the hooks are already in reset position. Now is the most important point. You see, your crew are coming out, your crew is hanging out the boat. Although the weather is calm, the sea is calm, the boat has got a certain movement, and the hook is also going to come close. As you can see, the boat is approaching close to the vessel. The floating blocks of the David, they come close to the crew member. Especially the forward crew member is restricted in movement. He has to pop out his head outside the hatch, so it is very dangerous for him. This situation is very dangerous. That is why we have tied, to avoid this situation, we have tied two ropes of 1 meter length each. You can see both the floating blocks have two ropes. Now the crew member has grabbed one of these ropes. This is for ease of access to the block, and the block does not hit the crew member or his head. It can be very critical and very dangerous, guys, if there is slightly a big swell in the water. So this is just to aid him to reach out to the block. And now there comes the coordination between the boat deck crew. They have to lower the block, lower it so much so that it can be easily put inside the hook. Now they are lowering the block from the boat deck, and the forward crew member is able to put it inside the hook. He is trying, but it is falling short from his hook. So now the boat deck guys have to lower it quickly and don't waste a lot of time in this. As you can see, now the floating block is slack and it is inside the hook. The forward crew member quickly has to go inside and close the hatch. Aft hook, aft floating block is slightly more comfortable position, and once both the blocks are inside the hooks, the boat is quickly heaved up just above the water to check if everything is okay. As soon as the weight is onto the blocks, the boat is retrieved 1/2 meter above the water. Then both the hatches are opened up and check whether the hooks are reset properly, and also the FPD is put in place. It is very important to put FPD back, guys, not only during launching but also during recovery. Check whether both the hooks are in green zone and everything is okay. Also, the lever from the coxswain position should be in its normal closed position, and the safety pin should be in place. Once that is done, guys, we are ready to be heaved up. Guys, this video was slightly long because it was really important to emphasize on all the safety measures to be taken during launching and recovery of the lifeboat. I hope you have understood the video and learned something from it. So next time you go on board, or if you are on board now and watching this video, few things which you need to know is, first, try to understand the procedure of launching and recovery on your boat, on board your ship, paying special attention to how to reset the hooks. guys, when we do a drill, it is a visual training only. You cannot have your hands-on training, because even during drills, it is a critical operation which is being carried out. You can train yourself very well when your vessel is out at sea, and when you don't have work, when you have free time, or during your routine drills of boat and fire every monthly. Also, as per SOLAS requirement, every week the lifeboat has to be swung out and has to be retrieved back. So this is the time you can have your questions cleared, your doubts cleared. So paying special attention to how to reset your hooks, what all things to check to ensure that your hooks are now reset, how to reset your hook from the coxswain position, and the difficulties that might come, weak signals that might show you that your hooks are not reset properly, and also very important is your close-up inspection of your boat falls, that is the wires of the boat. So these are few things which, if you pay attention, guys, I am pretty much sure that you will gain that confidence, and then this confidence is going to keep on increasing over and above everything else when you go from one ship to other ship, and when you use your experience on different ships. So guys, that's it for now. I hope you like this video and learn something from it. Please stay tuned to my channel for more such videos, and please don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Also, please press the notification icon so that any of my new videos, once released, you are well aware about it. That's it, guys, for now. I am Nawaf Qazi signing off. See you next time with a new video and with some new knowledge sharing. Bye bye for now.